guys, my name is Sculpting Gaming here with another video, and it's been a while since I've started talking one of my videos because I am out of summer vacation. I am still in summer, but my vacation is just over, so it's glad to be talking again. And also I want to thank you guys for 49 subscribers. We only have one more to go to get to 50 subscribers. I also hope that you guys like my new intro. I think it's pretty cool. I think it's really awesome. It's dope. Today I will be showing you how to literally block items from a specific place. And it's actually very, very simple. It's a simple command block creation that I will be showing you guys. So why don't you guys subscribe to my channel and like this video. And I'm going to be talking for the whole thing. One of the reasons why I didn't really talk in a lot of my videos, one, because I was on summer vacation and there was like too many sound going around, too many like family like talking, so I just got in a private place and there was still noise in a private place, so I just didn't talk at all. So I hope you guys like those videos. And also I got a new pet. His name is Bonnie the Bunny. I you guys might be thinking that like it's from like Five Nights at Freddy's, and yeah, I used to play Five Nights at Freddy's actually. So yeah, he's one of my new pets. And also I can't wait for the Better Together update, because once the Better Together update comes out, then I'm gonna also have a new pet, and it's gonna be a parrot. I'm thinking of some new names. Can you help me out with some new names for a parrot? That'll be awesome. So let's get on the things you need. You need a redstone comparator, a TNT, and a redstone repeater. So let's just go on to the testing facility right now. So as you can see, I just set this house down right here for an example to show you guys what it would be like to protect like a block, like a sexy place from horrifying items. This is pretty sexy. I like this house. So I'm just gonna go in creative mode right now. So the first thing you want to do is give yourself a command block by using give at p command block. Alright, so as you can see, first you are going to get the coordinates for your doorstep. Well, you're gonna get the coordinates for where you want to block this like TNT and all the other stuff. So I'm gonna go ahead and get the coordinates. Get the coordinates by using T/TP and three squiggly lines. I have no idea what they're called. I just call them squiggly lines. I know there is like a more specific way to say it. So actually there is, I actually got coordinates. So you're going to set the command blocks like so. And boom. Another command block. And simply like this. Yes, there we go. So you're going to set it up like that. And then the first command, you're gonna do first, leave it as impulse, because if you type the wrong command, it's going to lag you out of your game. I've been through this before, and I almost lost this world. I nearly lost this world. So first, you're going to do clear at p, and then you're going to do a bracket. So then you are going to look at your coordinates again, and make sure you put them in commas. So bracket -214, 68, 38. I'm not sure if I can remember that, but I'm gonna try. So 214, 68, 30. Yes, I got it. So then the next comma is gonna be the radius of 3. I've said this in my locking door command. So then you're going to do the item that you want to block, and TNT, 0 is the data, and 1 is how much you want to take from the griefer who wants to grief your house. So basically this is gonna work out pretty fast, because it's gonna be repeat and always active. So make sure you guys check that out. The repeat and always active. Now it's safe to put it in repeat and always active. So once I step here, then like the comparator should activate right here, and it should also take away all my TNT. So I'm gonna get all the way back. Okay, so the next command is, well, this is how you're gonna push them away from your house. So you're gonna do TP, and then you are going to get the coordinates for where you want them to teleport to once they're going away from your house. So I recommend, like, I don't know, I'm doing it right here. So I'm gonna do /TP squiggly line, the 3 squiggly lines. Okay, so I'm gonna do this. All right, so then I'm gonna hurry up before they disappear because I'm not gonna remember. Okay, TP at P, -213. I don't know what it is now. Let me go back and check it. 68 and 24. So I'm gonna do that. 68, 24. Okay, now the last command is that you wanna give away a message to saying that item is not allowed. So I'm going to do title at P, action bar, which will appear at the bottom of the screen. Action bar. You guys can do the same message as me. I don't care. So you're gonna do TNT is not. I'm gonna do all capitals, not allowed here. It's not allowed here, guys. Okay. So I'm going to try and test this out now. So I'm going to go right here. And then it should immediately teleport me back here and saying that TNT is not here. And as you can see in my inventory, I was right at 64 and now brought me back to 7. And I'm gonna go keep teleporting back. And now I only have 1 TNT left. And now all my TNT is gone. So, wait, what are you doing? What are you doing, Bonnie? Come over here. Okay, I forgot to bring out the carrot. Oh, wow, I forgot to unleash him. That's why he hasn't came. Okay, come on, Bonnie. Okay, so, so it should immediately teleport you back to where you want them to teleport. And it should also take away the griefer's item away so that he can't grief anymore. So, thank you guys for watching this video. I hope this helped you out with another command block creation. So why don't you guys subscribe to my channel if you have not and like this video, and also let's try to get the 50 subscribers. And I just love you guys, and it's really been a blessing to show you this video, and I'll see you guys next time. Peace out.